class, we are going to come back to our lesson. We have a continuation of our topic, money, we were doing previously. Today, with money, we are going to discuss a simple subtopic, hire purchase. A simple explanation of hire purchase, we see that hire purchase is a mode of payment whereby somebody chooses to buy an item. When you choose to buy an item, you can either pay an item on cash basis, whereby, for example, you go and find an item, for example, is costing, for example, 500 shillings, and you pay 500. You say you have bought an item on cash basis. But when you go to hire purchase, you find an item being sold, and you choose to pay this type of item slowly. Slowly, we say you buy an item slowly. We say that you buy it on what we call down payment. We call that mode of payment as hire purchase. I'll explain it further. When you talk of hire purchase, for example, you go and you find somebody, for example, is selling a car, for example, at 1 million shillings. Let me, we are giving ourselves an example. When it's being sold at 1 million shillings, at the moment you don't have the 1 million shillings. So what do you do? You choose to buy a car slowly by paying the money in monthly. That is what we call monthly installments. So here, for example, somebody will choose, for example, to give the first amount you pay. So this one, we refer it as the first amount which you will give the owner. So when you give the owner, first amount is 700 shillings. This first amount will give it a name, and that name will be given as the deposit. So we have given the first amount to the owner, which is a deposit. Then we still have to pay the balance, which is 300,000. How do we pay it? We can choose to pay it in 3 months, for example, 10 months. I write it well, 10 months. And you pay these 10 months, for example, as 30,000. So when you say you are paying 30,000 each month, we can now say that you have chosen to buy the car slowly, and this mode of payment is now the down payment. You are paying 30,000 each month. So that means that you would have paid the car whole amount at the end of the 10th month. We say you have bought it on hire purchase. So for instance, we say that hire purchase, at this point, hire purchase price will be equal to deposit. What is our deposit? Deposit, you have agreed it is the first amount of money you give. Then now you will pay the other money in what we call monthly installments. We agree what we mean by monthly installments. Yeah, monthly installments means that, for example, you will be paid, for example, 10,000 shillings. I give a different, or we can take our example previously there, which is 30,000 shillings for 11, for example, in we can say 10 months, for 10 months each. So this means what? I will say, for example, 30,000 each month, you are paying that 30,000. So we can place at there, meaning 10 months, each month you are paying 30,000. So at the end of it, you would have paid your 300,000 shillings. This means what? This is the balance which was to be paid after paying your first amount. So we agree what? At final, hire purchase price is equal to deposits plus the number of months. Now we agree, plus the number of months multiplied down by the amount which have given you to the name monthly installment. So we have agreed what we mean by that. The number of months each, the installment which you are paying each month, plus the first amount which was the deposit, it will end up giving us a total amount we are calling the hire purchase. So we have agreed up to that point. Now we take our example, very first year, so that we agree what we have said here. What have we said? First example, Moha bought a TV set on hire purchase terms by paying a deposit of 6,000 shillings plus 4 monthly installments of 1,300 shillings each. How much did he pay? So we have agreed that Moha have chosen to buy an item on hire purchase. Why mean that Viz has he chosen that? Might be he did not have the total amount of money for the TV. So he has chosen to buy it on down payment or in monthly installments. So we come back here, we say Moha, who is buying now the TV set on hire purchase, he will pay a deposit, which is the first amount, plus the number of months, plus the number of months, multiplied by the monthly installment. Now we are saying this one, all of it, we call it monthly installment, or the total monthly installments. So what we say, our deposit, we'll get it from here, which says, Moha bought a TV set on hire purchase terms by paying a deposit of 6,000 shillings. So in our case, our 6,000 becomes the deposit. So we copy it here as 6,000 plus, which is the one mentioned here, plus 4 monthly installments of 1,300 shillings each. What does this statement mean? I explain it again. This means what? 4 monthly installments of 1,300 shillings means that he was paying 1,300 shillings each month. So he paid it for 4 months. What does that mean? For 4 months, he was paying each month 1,300. And in our case here, each will be 5x multiplication. So for 4 months, how much did he pay? He paid 4 times 13, which is 52. We had 2 zeros. We say this is our similar way of multiplying. So in 4 months, he paid a total of 5,200 plus the first amount of money, which we say is the first amount of money which he paid, which was 6,000. So in total, how much has he paid for the TV set, which is 6,000 plus now the monthly installments of 5,400, which will give us a total of 11,200 shillings. You can say that was the higher purchase price for the TV set. We go to our example number 2. The market price of our TV set was 48,000 shillings. John bought it on higher purchase. So John bought it on higher purchase by paying a deposit of 20,000 shillings and 11 monthly installments of 3,000 shillings. How much more than the market price to be paid? Now, first case we agree, John bought the item on hire purchase. So, the purchase, when he went to the shop, the sofa set was costing 48,000. So that was the market price. What does that mean? If John had 48,000, he would have paid it cash and went home with the sofa set. But now, he did not pay it cash. Why? Maybe he did not have the total money. So what did John choose? He opted to pay it on hire purchase terms, which he was to pay in monthly installment. So what happened to John? John found the TV having a market price of 48,000. But John did not buy it on 40,000 shillings. He chose to buy it on hire purchase price. What does that mean? You cannot buy an item on cash and hire purchase at the same time. You choose one. If you have to buy it on cash, you remove the 14,000 from your pocket and pay. You say you have bought it on cash basis. But now John has chosen to buy it on hire purchase price. That means he will first give deposit, then plus the monthly installment, which will be paid number of months, each month giving some Monday installments. So we agree on that. So what happened to John? He paid a deposit of 20,000. So in our case, 20,000 becomes the deposit. So he paid a deposit of 20,000 plus 11 monthly, we are told that, and 11 monthly installment of 3,000. What does that again mean? Every month he was giving 3,000. So for 11 months, each month, so 11 months, each month giving 3,000. How much money did John give all together? We agree, he gave what? 11 times 3, which is the 3 plus 3 zeros. As we say, a simpler way of multiplying. Plus the first amount of money which John gave, which was 20,000. So in total, how much has John paid? He has paid the first amount, which was 20,000, plus the monthly installment of that 3,000. So how much in total has John paid? He has paid a total of 53,000. So you add the two. So 53,000 was our higher purchase, but the market price was 40,000. Here we come to our question. How much more than the market price did he pay? So did he pay? He paid 53,000. Market price was 40,000. How much more? How do we answer that question? The question how much more is answered by getting the difference between the two, the market price and the higher purchase. So we get the difference between the two. So the difference between the higher purchase and the market price, which was 40,000. What gives us the difference? 0, 0, 0. Borrow 1 year, we are left with 4. Bring it here, 13, take away 8, we are left with 5. So that means what? John paid 5,000 more. So we agree that. So in simple terms, we say more, we subtract the two. So we move very fast now to our example. We get more understanding of the questions. Kirui bought a record player on higher purchase. He paid a deposit of 1,300 shillings and 8 equal monthly installments of 250 shillings. The total amount paid was 10% more. It was 10% more than the cash price. What was the cash price of the record player? So we move very fast and agree. Number one, Kirui bought a record player on higher purchase terms. So if he bought the record player on higher purchase terms, it means that the higher purchase was deposit plus the number of months, as we have agreed previously, times the monthly installments. So the deposit, we are told he paid a deposit of 1,300 plus and 8 equal monthly installments of 250. That means that was they paid 8 months. For 8 months each, he was paying 250. So how much money is this? 8 multiplied by 25, which gives us 200 plus a zero. So he paid total monthly installments of 2,000 plus the deposit, which is 1,300. So this means he paid in total 3,300. So the 3,300 is higher purchase price. Now we also told the total amount paid, which is 3,300, was 10% more. What does that mean? It was more than the cash price. So that means this amount which he paid, which is 3,300, was 10% more than the cash price. That means that it is 100% plus 10, which means it is 110% than the cash price. So what was the cash price? It means our cash price was 100%. What about it? We cross multiply, which is 3,300 multiplied by 100%, all over 110%. Percent simplify percent, 0, 0. Sorry, we say, we repeat, percent simplify percent, 0 simplify 0. By 11, 1, by 11, 3. So we have 3 and then here. So we have 3 times 1, which is giving us 3. 1, 2, 3. So we have 3 zero. That means what? The cash price of the TV was 3,000. So we choose to move very fast. We have our fourth example, which we are taking it here. So very fast. We will read our question and then we take it very fast. Our question says, number 4, the market price of a TV set was 24,000, but a 10% discount is allowed on paying cash. The higher purchase terms for the same set are a deposit of 5,000 shillings, followed by 11 equal monthly installments of 1,800 each. How much more? Again, we are coming to find again the term more, which means we are supposed to subtract the 2 months of paying. So, how much more does one pay for the TV set on higher purchase terms and on cash? So that means we are getting the difference between higher purchase and cash. So we have to calculate the 2. So the first thing here we calculate here on somebody who has bought the item on cash, and again on somebody who have chosen to buy the item on higher purchase. We are told that the market price of a TV, the market price of a TV set is 24,000 shillings, but a 10% is allowed on paying cash. Now we come back here. When you pay the item cash, you get a 10% discount. What does that mean? If you are paying it, we draw a simple table. We are saying here, somebody has come to go to afford an item is at marked price. He is now given a discount. After being given a discount, he will now pay for the item. So as we said earlier, marked price of an item is always 100%. We forgot to mention, the marked price of an item is always 100%. So the marked price is 100%. But now, when you choose to buy cash, we have been told you are given a 10% discount. We say discount is money reduced from the market price. So if our discount is 100%, 10% will be given as a discount. So it means 100, 10% is reduced. So somebody will be able to pay 90%. What am I saying? 100% is the market price. Discount is the money reduced. So if it's 100, 10 is reduced, it means you are paying 90%. So we are told that the market price was 24,000. So how much is it now? He paid for cash. He paid 90%. So this one, we pick it as our reference point and say 100% was the 24,000. What about the 90% which is supposed to pay? So we cross multiply 90% times 24,000 all over 100%. Is this percent signify percent? 0 signifies 0, 0 signifies 0. So we take 24 times 9. So we have 24 times 9. 4 times 9 is 36. We have 6 carry 3. 2 times 9 is 18. Plus 3, which gives us 21. We have a 0 and a 0. So we have. That means that after being given a discount, you pay 21,600. Now, but here we are told that the higher purchase terms are also considered. So the higher purchase terms for the same set are a deposit of 5,000. So we have 5,000 being given as a deposit, followed by 11 equal monthly installments of 1,800 each. So that means, given the 3, we are able to calculate the higher purchase price. So we can go, higher purchase price is deposit plus the number of months, as we discussed earlier, times the monthly installments that way. So our deposit, we have been told that is given a deposit of 5,000. So we got our 5,000 here. Plus, we are told that followed by 11 equal monthly installments of 1,000 800, so followed by 11 months, and each month we are told he was paying 1,800. So this one we can multiply. 11, we multiply by 18, we get 198. We add the two zeros that way. So these are our total monthly installments plus our deposit, which is 5,000. So we add the two. So when we add the two, we get 24,800. So what is 24,800? It is our hire purchase price. Now in this case, we have our hire purchase price and we have our cash. Somebody paid the cash, he paid this. Somebody paid, bought it on hire purchase price, he paid this. Now we come back to our question, which is asking how much more. We agreed previously the question, how much more? It is the difference between the 2 months of buying. So the first month is this, this is the second. So we get the difference. So we say 24,800, we take away 21,600, we subtract. Here we have 0, 0, here we have 2, here we have 3. So we can say we pay 3,200 shillings more. So, Candice, that marks the end of our lesson today. As you have seen, so that is simply what we refer as higher purchase price. Thank you.